Generally, this Teflon is used as a layer in non-sticky, in the preparation of non-sticky utensils. The Teflon is used as a coating. And one more example for addition polymerization is polyacrylonitriles. Here, acrylonitriles are seems to be CH2 double bond CH single bond CN. When n number of acrylonitriles at high temperature, they undergoes addition polymerization in the presence of persulfates to produce CH2 CH CN N. The resulting compound is called as polyacrylonitriles. The polyacrylonitriles is producing from addition polymerization. It is used as synthetic fiber. It is used as synthetic fiber. And this is about addition polymerization or chain growth polymerization. Once again, the chain growth polymerization takes place in two different methods. One is ionic polymerization and second one is free radical polymerization. Again, ionic polymerization of two types, cationic polymerization and anionic polymerization. Those addition polymerization reaction initiated by cations are called as cationic polymerization, whereas the addition polymerization reactions, if initiated by anions, they are called as anionic polymerization. The same one, if any polymerization, addition polymerization initiated by free radicals, such type of polymerizations are called as free radical polymerization reactions. And next, one more important type of polymerization, the second type, condensation polymerization. Only two types of polymerization so far learned by us. Major type of polymerizations. First one is addition polymerization and second one is condensation polymerization. Here, condensation polymerization are also called as step growth polymerization. Step growth polymerization. So let us learn what is condensation polymerization, how it takes place, and for condensation polymerization, which type of monomers required for us. So once again, the monomers which wants to participate in condensation polymerization generally consists of, the monomers generally consists of bifunctional character, bifunctionalized or trifunctionalized compounds. What is that? Those monomers which wants to participate in condensation polymerization generally consists of bifunctionalized or trifunctionalized compounds, or bifunctionalized character or trifunctionalized character. When these functional groups reacts with each other to produce any polymer, generally elimination or loss of neutral species. Neutral species like water, alcohol, HCl, etc. takes place. Means, whenever in between two monomers, bond formation expected, during the bond formation, there is a loss of neutral species like water, alcohol, HCl, etc. Here, in each step, the produced dimers. For example, when two monomers reacts with each other to produce dimer, when dimer is going to react with one more monomer produces trimer. During this process to produce polymer, each step resulting compounds are having two functional groups. Each step resulting compounds are having two functional groups. Now these two functional groups reacts with each other, or these two functional groups reacts with one more monomers to produce a long polymer chain. Here let us learn some more examples for this examples for condensation polymerization. The first one is preparation of polyamides. Preparation of polyamides or polyamide linkage polymers are produced from condensation polymerization or step growth polymerization.